Hongrui, daughter of the moon, was preparing for a feast to celebrate Kohama's return from his war on the first ones of the Edomites. Tafor, son of the forest, asked each of the birds to sacrifice one of the kind for the feast. He gave these offerings to Ado Hongrui, who cooked them in a great firestone. Seeing all of those plump birds cooking made Kitava very hungry. He offered to watch them to make sure they didn't burn while Ado Hongrui rested during the heat of the day. Ado Hongrui thanked Kitava for his kindness. But while she slept, Kitava ate the cooking birds, flesh, bone,
gizzards.
Upon waking, Ado Hongrui was furious to find that Kitava had lied to her, for saying that he would watch the bird if he truly intended to eat them plump. When Tukohama arrived home in his mighty canoe, Ado Hongrui asked him to punish Kitava for his selfish gluttony. Tukohama, our father of war, agreed and pulled the sharpest tooth from his own mouth. To hold Kitava fast while he cut Kitava's face with the tooth. Two slashes that blinded Kitava and formed a bleeding cross upon his face. From that day forward, Kitava would never be able to promise to watch that which he truly intended to consume. Kitava to Hinekora, mother of death. They asked her to kill the greedy Kitava, for surely their tribe would starve if Kitava continued to live among them. But Hinekora refused, for death would not teach Kitava the lesson. Instead, Hinekora beat Kitava with a whip woven of her own hair. Kitava, each strand was a searing lash, and so he wore thousands and thousands of blistering lashes across his back as Hinekora drove him relentlessly into the darkest corner of the underworld. He would suffer without water or food. Lake his scorching thirst and satiate his ravening hunger. To replace the feast of birds that Kitava had greedily consumed, Kohama, father of war, and Valakor, father of storm, fishing. Although Kitava was blind, he could still cast his line.
Not all slaves